So the warm-up continues. Fourth meeting between these two. Joe, your thoughts on it?
Well, I think it'll be quite a battle. It always kind of depends on Anna, where she's at with herself, how she feels her confidence is, how she's hitting the ball, because we kind of know where Dominika's going to be in a match. Like, she tries to the bitter end, she can counter-attack, she plays some great dry volleys, actually. She's really added that to her tactics, in particular, this year.
And she won the first two of the meetings in the Kremlin Cup in Moscow 5 years ago in the round of 16. Tight, tight match too. Sibulkova won it 7-6 in the third, 7-4 in the breaker. Then a retirement win when a set up and three all in the second set in a Fed Cup match a couple of years ago on a clay court. Carlsbad this year they have met. Ivanovic getting her first win from a set behind. So it's never been easy. 4-6, 6-3, 6-2 for Anna in the round of 32. So she'll know that she'll need to be consistently hitting the ball well, because that's the big question always.
Well, that's the thing, you know, can she do it enough? Can she keep on at Sibulkova, go after the serve, use her forehand?
I think the team, the camera team, everybody are on a quick coffee break.
Yes.
It'll be produced soon. The route through for Anna Ivanovic. She beat Janina Wickmeyer, Belgian number two, ranked 64 in the world. Third on this court Tuesday, 6-2, 6-4. Was 3-1 down second set, Ivanovic, but got through in an hour and 14 minutes. Then she beat Francesca Schiavone, fourth on this court Wednesday, 6-3, 7-5. Was a 7-5, 3 up, Ivanovic. Eventually got it done in straight sets. Fifth win, never lost to Schiavone in an hour and 32. Sibulkova, she beat Annika Beck first on Tuesday, 6-1 in the third. Then she followed that up with a win against the qualifier Katarzyna Pita, the Polish number three. That was the first meeting against the Pole, ranked 158 in the world. She trounced a 6-love, 6-1. First up on Thursday, took under an hour. So plenty of life in the legs, that's for sure, of both these women with their routes through. Good to see her back up there, though, because she was 60-odd in the world a couple of years ago when it was all falling apart for Ivanovic, having reigned supreme at the top, having won the French Open, of course, in 2008. Nigel Sears did a good job, not saying that because he's a good friend of ours, Joe, but he got her back very close to the top 10 in the 2 years they worked together, but they parted company after Wimbledon this year.
Yeah, I think, you know, just a few clashes, obviously, there, and both feeling that they need to go in different directions.
Anna Ivanovic.
But she's very popular, obviously, wherever she goes to play, a style of tennis as well.
Particularly here, I mean, it's a sixth visit.
Yeah.
It's a sixth quarter-final, looking for a fourth semi-final, having won the title twice.
Something about the air in Linz.
Emmanuel Joseph from France, the chair for this one.
Dominika Sibulkova, given the ball on sick for Aufschlag. She won the toss 82 serve.
Yeah, Sibulkova serving first. Really does maximize everything. 5'3", 1m61, has been number 12 in the world. 6th of July 2009. She's currently ranked 23 in the world, Sibulkova. Fifth quarter final of the year, looking for a second semi. Always tough to beat.
Yeah, so you cannot lose your focus against Sibulkova, because you know she's just going to step in and take that opportunity.
The remaining quarterfinal of the WTA Generali Ladies in Linz, 23rd edition, international event. Kerber plays Carla Suarez Navarro in the bottom half semi-final. That'll be the first semi tomorrow. Winner of this will play Vergler, a debut semi-finalist, Stephanie, from Switzerland. Fourth meeting, Sibulkova leads 2-1, and we'll begin.
continue. 15.
Just have one of the strangest starts to serving Sibulkova. But saying that, you know, for her height, I think she has a tremendous serve.
She served five aces against Annika Beck on Tuesday. It's always like she's on a clay court, Ivanovic, wherever she plays, because she's sort of smoothing it out.
Yeah.
It's just habits.
Yes.
There she goes, look. Yeah, looking to get after that second serve. Big return and break point straight away.
I think we will be seeing it many times in this match.
Perfect start for Ivanovic. An immediate break.
Well, the one thing for big hitters when you play indoors, you know the ball isn't going to be wobbling around in the wind, so you can set up for your shots very confident that you know where the bounce is going to be. And that's why they like playing indoors. I mean, Kvitova is a very good indoor player as well. That's tough for Sibulkova in the very first game.
Not the best start for them, after all their hard work. Nice. Really good start this from Ivanovic. Full of confidence, hitting the ball beautifully. Yeah. And then this.
Just a little move in behind it as well, just in case.
Ranked 18 in the race, Ivanovic. She's qualified for the season end twice. In 08, she made semi-finals. That was the year, of course, she won the French. Didn't get through the group stage the following year, but we've had a tweet from Jake Fletcher, Joe, because, of course, for many, many, many years, season end championships... Yeah. Was always at Madison Square Garden where you played. And he wants to know that your memories from those times.
Yeah, fantastic. What an arena. It was absolutely buzzing there. It really was.
Fourth five aces against Wickmeyer, two against Schiavone. And they obviously went and wanted to sort of share it around and go to different places. Yeah. LA, it went to Germany, of course, it went to Doha, now Istanbul. And your thoughts on all of that?
I think that basically, you know, with Steffi Graf, Monica Seles, it became more European-centred. That's why they wanted to move it.
Brilliant service game, two aces. This is a very impressive start.
Yeah, she couldn't be more pleased, I'm sure, to time everything like this at the very beginning. Looks painful.
But it does sound something magical about playing Madison Square Gardens.
Yeah, a lot of history, a number of events they've had there. Of course, that's where they had the first five-set matches for women in the finals. A lot of talk about that. There's been some talk lately about that,
actually.
There has.
Your thoughts?
Oh, I just don't see how they can fit it all in. I think, you know, the women are very willing, absolutely, to play five sets, but you try and fit it all in to a Grand Slam. If it's long five set followed by another, you just can't do it.
Thanks for that, Jake. I think we might get a few more tweets now.
That's just too short. Vanovic is standing so far up the court to wait for it.
On the scoreboard, Sivakova. First sit down. Ivanovic with the break. 2-1, first set. Just under 10 minutes. Double fault, first point, fourth game. Sorry we're late.
Yeah, that was all over the place with the ball toss. Very uncertain serve.
She only served one double fault in each of her previous matches, Ivanovic. Good recovery.
From Simbasic, 15-30. Clement Fossis.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
I mean, two double faults and two sublime points from Ivanovic. How difficult is it to play against this?
Amazing. Well, if she doesn't break here. Oh.
What a chance.
Yeah, no wonder she's going for the worry blanket. That reaction, and we always look for that lately too. How tolerant is she going to be?
Well, that obviously didn't feel very good to her, the timing or execution. Oh. I thought she got a hold of that one, Sibulkova. Off sideways. Yeah, I think Sibulkova is very capable of attacking. You leave it too short, she will be after you.
Ivanovic thought that ball was out. Looked good from here.
Mm. Well, it's very difficult to tell on that one. But she knows, actually looked in, that it's not going to be changed, so you have got to get on with it.
Hawkeye not here. It's a 235,000 international event. Hawkeye can cost up to around 100 grand to install.
Yes, a big slice of the budget, isn't it?
Good response again from this hiccup game. Yes.
Ah!
such a strength when it's working well, the serve.
Yeah, when she gets it right, the ball toss is in a good position.
It's a brilliant hold. Three break points saved. Double faults in the game. Contested calls. It had just about everything.
Yeah, and very good movement, I think, from Ivanovic. A couple of times I thought she'd be in a bit more trouble than she was moving across. But she's striking the ball beautifully and then moving from that shot to the next one right here. Very easily getting behind it.
Just delayed it well too to make the Slovakian choose a side. Standing so far in.
Some good length from Sivakova. She's got to try and force Ivanovic back from that baseline.
A lot of eye contact always with whoever's in the support camp.
A little too obvious at the end where Ivanovic was going to hit that. The racket angle was set.
Good game. Stay tight on the scoreboard, Sivakova. Ivanovic 3-2 the lead. After 20 minutes. Well, I asked you this earlier on in the week, Joe, but for those who weren't with us, she's ranked 16 in the world, the former world number one. Will she, can she? Well, we know she can, but do you think she's going to feature in the top 10 again in her career?
Did you ask me that question earlier?
I did. Thanks for listening.
I'm going senile. Well, I might answer it differently now, you never know. I think she's got the tennis to do it. That obviously hasn't gone away. But it's the confidence. It's the top 10 confidence that she needs in herself, the belief.
Pretty similar answer. Ivanovic, 3-2 first set.
Bit of an extravagant error there from Sibulkova. Sort of improvised a shot there, Ivanovic.
Looks like she really played for it, though, didn't she?
Yep.
Cleverly done. She served really well all week. I know she served two doubles in the last service game, which was a bit of an itchy moment, but overall this week she has served magnificently. 14 from 17 behind her first serve. Mum and dad must be pleased. Hitting partner at the front. 4-2 the lead, 4 points in a row. Very nice mixture of power and touch. It's a good combo. So easy to rush these when you've caused the short ball and you're sprinting in. That's lovely control. Just outplaying Sibulkova at the moment. 6 points in a row.
Classic 15-30.
15:40.
So needs a few good first serves now.
Two more break points. Well done.
Yeah, bold play. Absolutely launching herself at that one. And then the follow-up, just as good.
Fantastic resistance. It just sort of sums up Sybil Kova, really, this game. Such a hard worker. There's no substitute.
Second. Left. Second.
This could have a lot of air on this one. This could be very hittable, this second serve now. To make sure it goes over. Break point of the game. Dripping off Sybil Kova with her efforts.
She's just not sitting back letting things happen to her, Sybil Kova, at these times. I do like the way she can combine her defence with the attack.
Tough game. It was long.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit of a bluff that time.
I think so. Just really wanted it to be in.
Yeah.
But I think she knew it wasn't.
It's closer than I first thought.
Yeah.
Just beautiful timing on that return. Just little shift to her left and beautifully stroked to create the short ball.
Well, with that positioning as well, then you can hit it any way you like on the court if you've made the effort to get your feet around the ball.
Read it so well, stayed put, thumps the winner and gets the double break. It's 5-2 for the third seed in this opening set. Good match.
Yeah, it is. Oh, there's lots going on. It just sort of, where they're standing on the court, is Sibulkova going to take it on a little bit more or not? If she doesn't, hit it to length, then Ivanovic is absolutely getting onto the ball straight away. Very sharp.
We've had an interesting tweet from Gene Murphy. I mean, he's ahead of the game a little bit, because Ivanovic, he's saying if she won the title here, an international event, they of course have the Tournament of Champions at the end of the year for eight women that don't make the season-end championships. And he's asking the question of, if she wins this, what happens then with the wild card?
Well, it's an interesting one. It's Sibulkova's coach.
Natasha Liptak.
Quick chat. But I know that Maria Kirilenko said that she's not going to play Fed Cup final. She's going to play in the tournament in Sofia. So it brings up an interesting conundrum, I suppose, if she gets there. But they're saying that Vinci, Halep, Kirilenko, Vesnina, Korne, Hantikova and Pironkova are in it.
Interesting. New balls for Ivanovic, serving for the opening set. Apology for the let cord. The sort of errors that she can ill afford. They work so hard. Yeah, I'd love 30 chances again for Sibulkova, but
yeah. Didn't put quite enough stick on the ball, did she, with that attacking one? She just gave Ivanovic a chance to get back into it.
She's really loved that serve this week, out wide, the deuce court. Another beauty, sets up set point. Grueling.
That was relentless from Sibulkova. Just kept going to the space with the angle. Oh, wonderful timing.
To go down, a long way to hit it too. Second set point. We'll do it. A 6-2 for Ivanovic. Felt a little bit tougher than that. Took the chances though. Just under 40 minutes. Sits down with a one set lead.
Yeah, it's a tough set for 6-2, wasn't it?
That Roland Rat we've seen all week.
You're popping up here and there.
Emily Boniface. She seems to enjoy the toy. So Sibulkova, much of the same, but just tighten up on the sort of the unforced occasionally.
I mean, like you, Chris, I didn't feel there was actually much between them in that set, and you know, a couple of very long games at the end of the set. It was very hard fought. I just think that Ivanovic is just flowing off her racket a little bit easier than Sibulkova. She's got very good positioning on the court. And Sibulkova, you know, trying to do her thing, trying to keep it deep and then hitting angle to get Ivanovic on the run. But I have to say, Ivanovic is moving very well.
Yeah, it's been very impressive. Hasn't dropped a set in the tournament yet, Ivanovic. Yep, they have come a long way, is the end of that slogan. Baby, the WTA, celebrating 40 years this year. From the $1 contracts, the original nine. These two have won nearly 15 million between them. Sibulkova to get the second underway. And she doesn't want to start as she did in the first by immediately dropping her serve. Second double. Doesn't serve many. Three against Beck, two against Kalazina Peter.
yet again. The return doing its job. Standing right up the court, and she's got all the court to aim for. One of her favourite returns as well. A little bit irritated she missed it.
So a good start to the second set for Cibulkova. It's a confident walk always.
Yes, I think anyone who plays against Cibulkova knows they're in for a tough time, because there's been a number of times, even her first match this week against Annika Beck, who played very well, lost the first set and just kept plugging away. And you know she will do that, so you just can't give away too much to her.
It's a good touch.
It's a nice position to be in if you are up to the shorter ball, nice and quick. And then it's easier to play this one back. A little hesitation there, I thought. She saw her opponent move and she wanted to hit line, but then wasn't sure if she should do it.
Shame, because it's such a brilliant return at the start of the point.
Nice thing, Vina. Suit you.
There you go, Chris. Scraping the line as though it had clay on it.
Yeah. So good, so positive.
Well, I think Ivanovic knew that was coming from the second serve. But kept on with the power, Cibulkova.
Break point. Save three already. Fourth game of this match, Ivanovic. Not this time. Gifts it with a break and a double fault. Head start, second set for Sibulkova.
Yep, you just never count her out of a match. Extraordinary the way that she just keeps fighting. Make something happen. Yep, I think Sibulkova is rather relishing this now. But the right move, showing her opponent she's going to be a bit more aggressive. Something that Dominika did so well, I remember in the final of Stanford when she went set down to Radvanska and was not in the match at all. Then she definitely started coming in, taking more out of the air, attacking more, being bold, and it won her the match.
Amazing turnaround, wasn't it, having lost Love and Love in the final of Sydney to the same player. Maybe exhausted after some amazing wins. Super return.
Ivanovic, absolutely doing the right thing. Make your opponent play. They come into the net on a ball like this, especially a dipping ball.
Break back points. Great play. Flirting with the lines.
Yeah, I like the way Sibulkova makes the decision, though. She absolutely knows she should attack, so there's no questioning herself. Off she goes, leaps on it.
This is the question. She has got the greater weight of shot, Ivanovic, but does she have the consistency now Sibulkova's got into this terrific form? Can't miss at the moment, Sibulkova. Three love it is. Two break points saved. This is a terrific response from the Slovakian at the start of this second set. Well, it's two-way, but there was quite a bit of, I would imagine, try and stay positive here to Ivanovic. Her opponent is playing some wonderful tennis at the moment. It is well worth a three love lead, second set. Big service game this for the Serb.
Quite a few looks down the court from Dominika. But the trusty serve out wide comes to the rescue. They're looking a little bit more worried, Anna's supporters.
Good, very good.
Had to come in, was almost pulled in there, but that's good touch to finish. What a very late decision to try for the drop shot.
She's winning three quarters of the points behind her first serve, Ivanovic. And that's good, first serve again, but not even a quarter behind a second. Sibulkova, 58% behind first serve, 50% behind a second. So this is the test for Ivanovic to up the points one behind second serve. Well, that's a good hold to stay in this second set, really.
Yeah, love 30. I thought, well, if she loses this game, the set's over, more or less. But still capable of swinging at a few, connecting, getting some quick winners and just turning this match around in a flash. She's very dangerous, Anna, when she's on the hunt. Just swivels into that return, standing so far up the court.
Wow. amazing how well she hits the ball.
Yeah. It really is, and over the years she's learnt how to do this, to take those balls on, hit it a bit harder, you know, take the chances and not mind if you miss a couple.
Oh. Well, it takes some doing to get one by Sybil Kova. So quick.
It's just easy power, isn't it? Something that she's had all her tennis life.
God, she first burst onto the scene. She took everyone's breath away.
Yep.
Match against Venus Williams in Zurich all those years ago. Two tie-break sets. She had set points in both sets. It's a very young player. 2004 Zurich.
Oh, that's a nice change up too. Again, the body movement into the shot, helping the shot.
15-40.
Two more break points. Had Sybil Kova 15-40 as well in the last service game. Sybil Kova just played too well. Careful. Not this time. Anna Ivanovic has played too well. She's broken back. 2-3 in this second set now. Well, Sybil Kova demanded the very best from Anna Ivanovic. The problem is she got it. Back on serve this second set.
Well, that was crunched down.
From Sybil, 15. Nice.
Wow, off the line again. Aces 5 and 6.
39.
Nearly 7.
6 feet tall, 1.84 meters. Great use of the height when it all sort of flows nicely together. Such an advantage. Sybil Kova, 5'3", 1.61 meters. First love game of the match. And quickly levels at 3-all second set. Pressure back on the Slovakian.
Yes, didn't those three games go quickly from 3-love down? Momentum has shifted rapidly again. And exactly, you know, what we were talking about, Chris, earlier on, that Ivanovic has the capability of doing that with the way she hits the ball.
This is a fabulous passage of play. It really is.
Again, it's the movement for me, you know, not only sprinting across the court, but around the ball with the little steps that Ivanovic is putting in to balance herself before she strikes.
Well, if this keeps up, this match is going to slip away from Sybil Kova very, very quickly. This is danger time here.
Great defence again from Ivanovic.
Well, that's just pressure. The quality of play that she's facing. Three more break points. Well, it breaks the run of points.
Yes, it was 10 in a row.
15-14. Momentum's such an amazing thing, isn't it? Because if you don't take it, then you can have another turnaround.
And you always think, you know, in tennis, three in a row, going to get one, especially with a big hitter, they're going to go for it.
Oh, that's fantastic. Wow. Four games in a row from Ivanovic. Unplayable tennis. Look at this. From line to line. Set 4-3 the lead. First serve into the net, going for the T serve, Ivanovic. First point, eighth game. In her first two rounds. That's so good. Ball again coming out the
shorts.
Thank you. Thanks for helping me out there.
Yeah, but it has happened how many times this week for Anna? There's one in particular when it the ball dropped and she almost tripped over it, but her opponent volleyed it and she tried to argue. But if you've done it to yourself, it's bad luck.
From 15-14.
Well, she's that sort of opponent, Sybil Coe. No matter how well you play, you've got to keep it up. She's always going to be there, badgering away. Break back points. Hats off.
Yep, really well done. She didn't get all down on herself, having the lead and then a flurry of winners from Ivanovic. She just kept sticking at it.
As you've said many, many times over the years, Joan, the women's game takes all shapes and sizes. Mm. They can all get there and get tremendous results.
Yes.
Cibulkova picking out a new racket, but then immediately standing on the strings because it's too tight. There must be one in there that's not as tightly strung.
Well, you'd think. No. This is going to be a crunch game.
New balls in play for all second set. They're both giving as good as they're getting.
Yes. Well, as Ivanovic just upped it slightly again. Even off the first serve, she's looking to stand right up.
Bit lucky.
Very lucky. I mean, she obviously meant to hit it, but where it landed, I mean, it's almost a perfect miss hit that short.
Three more break points. Three of the last four games have been breaks. What a chance.
Did not go after that with the same relish as we've seen some of the forehands, Ivanovic. Little hesitation.
It is three breaks in a row. Andrei Ivanovic, two times former champion here, will serve for a place in the semi-finals. Set 5-4 the lead. Hour and a quarter, Ivanovic serving for the match. Ooh, just wide.
Well, Cibulkova was all over that return, straight off. Made her mind up she's going to attack. The head. And what kind of shot she was really aiming for there? It turned out to be a nothing shot. Good running, lovely angle, follows it up.
Close.
Well, you wouldn't have expected anything different from Sibulkova. The way she's come out and attacked this game is just fantastic. Two lifeline points. 15-14. That's what you mean about taking it on, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
Yeah, there's no faltering there.
She's one of those players who plays through instinct, Ivanovic. You can see it and hit it. And sometimes I think it's better for her not to think about it.
Oh, she served a double fault to concede a serve last time round. Three breaks a serve in a row, remember?
Yeah, opted for the harder down the line pass. I don't really know if you're going to connect with it right. It's much easier to brush up the back of the ball to go cross.
Match point now. She's got it. Wins it in straights. She's delighted with that. 4 points in a row from 15-40. What a terrific quarterfinal that was.
Yeah, I didn't think that was going to be straight sets, that's for sure. But she got herself together. You know, after going three love down, she didn't get too hard on herself or lose too much confidence and just kept attacking the serve. And went after it. Great match.
Two times former champion can look forward to a fourth semi-final here in Linz. And Sibulkova, well, she played her part. It looks a pretty comfortable score, doesn't it? 6-2, 6-4. It belies the match. Here's Barbara Schett.
Dominika, she's a tough cookie to beat. How was it for you out there today?
It was a very tough match. You know, I really played well in the first set. I hardly did anything wrong. And then in the second, I dropped a little bit. She started to hit the ball a lot harder. And she gave me a very tough match, but so happy to pull through.
What were you the most happy with in your game today and overall throughout the whole tournament so far?
Well, I was really happy with my aggressive game in the first set, and then, you know, my serve held well in the second, and, you know, just coming in, hitting a lot of volleys, which I was working on, so I'm really pleased with that.
Probably a surprise, the next opponent you're facing, Stefanie Vögele. Are you happy about that draw?
Well, she's been playing really well lately. I watched that match. You know, she gave Stevens a very good run, and she's very young. I know her for a long time. We used to play club matches together in Switzerland, so a very nice girl, so I expect a tough match.
But only two matches away from the hat trick. Good luck.
Yes, four titles. I'm sure Vögele is absolutely delighted with the draw. She's in the semi-finals.
Quite, yes. There's a lot of stuff going on from the Ivanovic end of the court, but, you know, Sibulkova fought hard to get back in that, and as Anna said, she was much more aggressive in the second.
So the stage is set for the second.